and value-adding step, what are the techniques that you have to use in order to evaluate? You don't rely on your common sense. Yeah? To design a pencil, you know, in Japanese companies, because I also am a consultant of some major companies in the Philippines, also elsewhere. This pencil, in some companies, they use it up to this end. So what do you do in your company when it reaches probably this end? They throw it, right? So what the companies are doing is, they put a tape here, and actually maximize everything. The use of the pencil. So this kind of a technique, we actually teach this. Giving the people different, we call it critical eye. Critical eye, that's different. It's difficult to learn that. You have to get it from, you know, somebody who knows it. This is what we tell you. Of course, it's a soft skills, it's a technique. All right?
So I may have missed it, you know, I'm very interested on the Six Sigma approach.
Yeah.
Is this like, I may have missed it on your presentation. Is it like an international, how would
yes.
you be able to be taught? Is it a certification?
Yeah.
Maybe it's originate, you know, like we're all familiar with like ISO, like HACCP.
Yeah.
Okay, so Six Sigma,
yeah. as I have explained earlier, Ronald Reagan approved the law of Malcolm Baldrige Quality National Award. They selected a company in the US and they picked a company called Motorola. So they entered the company of Motorola, they checked the efficiency and effectiveness, cost, very, very low cost, high quality, high delivery product. They asked the people there, what are you doing? Why are you achieving this? And they found out that what they are using, they call it measure, analyze, improve, control. According to Bill Smith, the founder of Six Sigma, he calls it Six Sigma. Six Sigma, okay? In the beginning, it's L-A-I-C. But Motorola lost the competition, right? They bought a lot of satellites because the marketing of Motorola is you can be reached anywhere in the world. It's hard to search on Amazon. But your cell phone is like this big. It was out-competed by which telephone company? Nokia. Because Nokia asked the customers, what do you want for your phone? Do you want that big? Or do you want a phone with a camera, with the music? That's the voice of the customer. That's Six Sigma. Yeah? So Nokia outcompeted Motorola. So Jack Welch was so witty. He learned from Nokia. He moved Six Sigma to GE. And he added the word define. That's why now it's called define, measure, analyze, and control. You define first what the customer wants. So wrong definition of define, that's a no-no. That's a no-no. So you start with the define. So that's Six Sigma. So it became a responsibility of the winner of MBQ&A to propagate the learnings in the US. So what did Motorola do is put up a Motorola University. And the most expensive Six Sigma practitioners today are Motorola guys. So when I was the Pfizer director, I called the black belt to coach one of my black belt in Hong Kong. I called the Motorola guy and said, how much will be paid? The Motorola guy says, it's not $7,000.